Hello, everybody, and welcome back. My name is Josh Jepson, but you knew that already. Today, I wanted to announce something huge, the biggest thing I've ever announced for this channel. I got a couple of comments saying that the new waveform aesthetic and like the white was very bright and distracting from the game. So I'm pleased to announce dark mode. That's it. That's the whole announcement. Let's play some Banjo-Tooie, shall we? Man, what was I doing last time? It feels like it's been like a year since I played last, but it was like 2 days. So I don't. Oh yeah, I was gonna do Mumbo stuff. We're gonna do Mumbo stuff. Oh, but you know what? There's something that I need to do that's very important before I do anything with Mumbo Jumbo. Something that many of you may have noticed in the last video. I may or may not have forgotten a jiggy, maybe two jiggies. I did the whole thing and then forgot to pick up the jiggies. Listen, it's fine. I got distracted. I don't know what I was talking about, but I got distracted. So let's go do that immediately and hope that they're still there. Okay, they are still there. Sick. Wait, why are they up so high? Are they always up that high? I guess they are. I seem to recall them being lower than that for some reason, but I might just be like remembering incorrectly. All right, anyway, free jiggies, let's go. I didn't have to do shit. That was great. Oh no! Sorry, that was a little bit of a panic attack there. Okay, so now that we've done that, let's go back to what we were doing. Back into the inferno, thrown into the fire. And get Mumbo and do some stuff with him. So another thing that I wanted to mention is, I can do this right now before I go get Mumbo. A few videos ago, people commented saying that there is something that you get from Grunty, from Madam Grunty, I was gonna call her a predictionist. what's the term for that? Like a person who tells fortunes, a fortune teller. She gives you something. What is it that she gives you? People told me what it was, now I can't remember. Ah, welcome. I will now choose your fate. You win extra grenade eggs. See, it's like usually stuff like that where she gives you either refills or like takes your life. But one of the times that you go in here, she will give you like a bonus. I will now choose your fate. You win extra fire eggs. See, like that's great and all, but like what about the thing that I want? Well, now choose your fate. You win some gold feathers. Cool. I don't need any. What about like, man, she's like not beating me up at all either. Of course I say that and now she's gonna beat the shit out of me. Yeah, see? But like one of the times it's like random chance that she gives you, shoot, I wish I could remember. I should have looked this up before I started recording. She's gonna give it to me and I'm gonna be like, oh yeah, that's right. I will now choose your fate. You win extra fire eggs. Cool, 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 cool. Should I just keep doing this? Oh, you can't. Madam Grunty's tent is closed temporarily for refurbishment. What the frick? I didn't even know that happened. Hold on, I'm gonna look it up real quick. Oh yeah. Okay, so, okay. It's not important really, but she will give you the Get Jiggy cheat, which I forget what that does exactly. Does that just give you extra? Oh, that's right, it gives you the hints. Okay, so in Jiggy Wiggy's temple, there's a bunch of signs that are around and you can't read them. And if you use the Get Jiggy cheat, it will let you read those signs. It'll give you hints to certain jiggies. I don't know, it's not that useful because it's not like every jiggy in the game. It's just like a handful of jiggies. Maybe that are like difficult to find or something, but it's not that important, so I'm not gonna even like bother, but if you do that, like it's a random chance. I wonder what the chance is of her giving it to you. If you're extremely lucky, she'll give you the Get Jiggy cheat. That's all it says on the Banjo-Kazooie wiki page. So, I don't know. Fun fact, so I mentioned that I had to re-record some stuff, which is why the Jinjos are all different. I got that like first try. I talked about the Get Jiggy cheat and got that first try. That was like a month ago or 2 months ago even. But so I was kind of hoping that would happen again, but Yeah, it didn't. So I can confirm that that is a real thing. Something that I did not know. The comments section let me in on it. So thank you to your wonderful comments. There's been great comments lately, lots of great feedback, and also like some little hints and stuff about Banjo-Tooie that I wasn't aware of. Because I'll reiterate this. I am not as familiar with Banjo-Tooie as I am with the first game. So your comments, like giving me little like hints and secrets that I didn't know about, super, super helpful. There's a lot of little things that you know, people have commented that I do know about that, or like I know partially. So like I'm feeling a little bit validated by that. But there's been several things that people have mentioned that I never heard of before in my life. So keep those coming. Keep those comments coming. Especially about like future things that are about to happen. You know, like, yeah, like whatever. You can comment about like the last world of the game. I don't give a shit. So like if there's something hidden in Cloud Cuckoo Land that you don't, you know, that I've never heard of before, not that you would know, but like you can guess. And, you know, if there's any like cool little secrets or whatever, leave a comment. Let me know. I want to know about these things. Let's go do the Mumbo things. There's three things to do with Mumbo. We opened up the beginning here. I hope this stayed open. Okay, thank God. I wasn't sure if it was going to... it's not like I turned the game off. I just went into, like, sleep mode. The cool thing about Banjo-Kazooie on the Xbox version of Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie is that they are available in the Rare Replay Collection, and the Rare Replay Collection is available on Xbox Game Pass now. You cannot play it, well, okay, that's an asterisk, you cannot play it on PC. You technically can, but only through their cloud gaming service. So like you're playing it with the internet connection. You don't have to download it or anything, which for some people might be really convenient. For me, not so much. I felt like it didn't like work super, super well. But if you have Game Pass Ultimate or Xbox Game Pass on your Xbox, you can just play this game at no additional cost. So I highly encourage you who have not played, if you've not played this version of Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie, to go try them out. Especially because, you know, Tooie's not available on the Nintendo Switch Online yet. And I'm hoping that, you know, in sometime in the next year or whenever, especially if the Nintendo Switch Online games carry over to the whatever the Switch successor is, which I'm very hopeful for. You know, if that happens, I really hope that we get Banjo-Tooie and like Diddy Kong Racing and all these other Rare games. You know, they've had a pretty good track record. We talked about it last time, but they have a pretty good track record of releasing the Rare games like GoldenEye and Jet Force Gemini and Banjo-Kazooie on the Nintendo Switch Online. I just hope that they keep that trend going and just have all of them. I mean, Diddy Kong Racing really should be there, and so should Donkey Kong 64. The fact that those two games are not on there, two of the greatest, asterisk, games on the Nintendo 64. Yeah, I don't know, they should have them. I say that only because Donkey Kong 64 is a beast of a game. It's fun, like the first time you play Donkey Kong 64, it's a very fun experience. Lots of exploration, lots of collectibles, things to find, cool things to unlock or whatever. If you try even remotely to go for 100% in that game, that's a terrible idea. Do not do that. Not a good idea. I think the next time that I play Donkey Kong 64, one things that I think would really improve that game is being able to switch Kongs at any time. And that would cut down significantly on the amount of backtracking that you have to do for all of the extra collectibles for the different Kongs. And there's a mod. If you play it on an emulator on the PC, you can get a mod for Donkey Kong 64 that lets you change Kongs anytime you want. And it really, I don't think that like detracts from any of the gameplay at all, honestly. So I think next time I play Donkey Kong 64, I will do that. Because I have 102%? I have 102% of the game, which I think is a stupid concept already. But I have done that before, gotten literally everything in the game before. And I don't think I will ever do that again. And it's too bad because that was before I started, Especially when this is so loud. Oh my God. The Ikabokum chant is so freaking loud compared to everything else in the game. What was I even talking about? Oh, so before I saved my VODs for my streams. So that playthrough just doesn't exist anymore, which is kind of too bad, right? So if I were to ever do it, I'd do a stream of it and just have the mod that lets you switch Kongs whenever you want. All right, so that's everything to do with Mumbo. We activated the Star Spinner, we activated the Dodgem Dome. and we activated the... I never did this. I'm going to show this off because I think this is hilarious. If you take Mumbo into Wumba's wigwam, you get a little extra cutscene. Mumbo not welcome. Leave now or be in big heap trouble. That's it. And then you go into her pool and she's like, Mumbo, get out of pool. That's it. She just hates Mumbo for no apparent reason. They're rivals, I guess. Two magic users, you know, fighting it out, duking it out. They just hate each other. I get it though, Mumbo's kind of dumb. Oh, I was supposed to warp. What am I doing? I was supposed to warp back to the Inferno. Here, we'll just go up here. Can Mumbo climb this hill? Okay, he can't, but you can jump up of it. Up of it. Jesus, I can't talk today. It's fine. I'm doing my best. Here, hold on. Let me have a quick coffee break. Brought to you by Madrina's. You can go to madrinas.coffee/Josh Jepson. Get 20% off Madrina's coffee and other drinks. I think they're introducing a bunch of new beverages this year too. So check it out. Consider supporting the channel. Let's go get Banjo and Kazooie back because I'm over it. Mumbo's so boring. I wish Mumbo was more interesting. He's just so boring. Because when you first get him, it's like, oh, it's cool. You can play as a different character. But nah, he doesn't really do much. He's just like a glorified extra button, you know? So you should go push a button and come back. Alrighty. Let's see. Okay, so which thing should I do first? Let's go back to Wumba, actually, because there's something. I need to unlock the Dodgem Dome again. So I need the money van to pay to get into that ride. So we'll probably do that first. We'll probably do the Dodgem Dome first. Why not? Adjust it here. So I wanted to say while we're doing this, after Banjo-Tooie is finished, which, you know, it'll be a little bit yet. We're still early game. Once Banjo-Tooie is finished, I want to do a bunch of one-off videos and play some games that are a little different. So if you have any suggestions for games to play for one-off videos, leave them in the comments. Let me know. Let me know if there's anything you really want to see me play. I'll try to do some, like, you know, so, something that I wouldn't necessarily do a full series of, but I might do one video on, you know? All right, that's it. Dodgem Dome open. God, the Dodgem Dome. The Dodgem Dome. Man. So much greatness here. Actually, before we do the Dodgem Dome, you know what would be good? I think what we should do is go across the top of the level and do everyone's favorite Saucer of Peril. So that's what we're gonna do next. Widgie World is such a great and varied level. There's just so much to do. I've been enjoying it. I don't enjoy this guy though. Yo, what's up, dude? Can you see me? Do you see me? Ugh. Man, this is so cruel, though. It's like, oh, the thing is over there. You gotta, like, tightrope walk to get to it, which I guess is very in the theme of this level, though, isn't it? Oh, shoot. Wait, can I get back up there? Can I get back up there? Please let me get back up there. I need to hit that button. Why is the button up there? This is terrible design. This is a terribly designed ride. Like, does the ride operator have to land on that button every time to activate the thing? Who even operates any of these rides? I guess it's the rat. Oh, he's already back. Man, these enemies spawn so fast. Is it all the enemies in the game that respawn that quickly? I feel like the ones in Witchy World respawn extra fast. But maybe it's because it's like Grunty's world, you know? Experience the scenic splendor of the cable car ride. Let's do it. Banjo, you're a little close to the edge there, buddy. You have so much to live for, Banjo! Don't do it! I love that transition. Because it has to match the theme of the new area, I guess. I don't know. It's kind of neat. Banjo out here performing some alchemy on the rides. Okay, yeah, so. Oh, shoot, this is activated because I turned on the Mumbo thing already. I love how visceral these lightning bolts are. It's little electrical holes, I guess? I don't know. It would make sense that Grunty's carnival is, like, run down, though. Somebody needed to come in here and do some electrical work. It's the Saucer of Peril. Man, I got a bone to pick with the Saucer of Peril. This version of it isn't too bad. I think that a lot of people have struggled with this the first time they're playing it because of the weird aiming. But man, they brought this back in Nuts and Bolts, and it is bad. Genuinely terrible. Bleep. Jump aboard to ride the exciting Saucer of Peril. Bleep. Let's do it. Bleep. It's so cool though, isn't it? When the crosshair appears, press LT or RT to fire at the targets to score points. Blue targets are worth 3, green are worth 2, red only 1. To give you a chance, I'll give you some special eggs. Score 500 points to win first prize or 400 for the second prize. Bleep. Little do you know, if you get 500, you get both. So you can just get both prizes. I wonder if there's anybody who's ever gotten all of the targets. There are some places in this shooter where, like, I feel like it would be impossible to get every target because you just go by so quickly. You can get like one or two of the targets. Like these first few, you can get all the targets, but like it gets a point where you just like pass by them so fast that like how would you get them all? I'm sure somebody has though. It feels like it would be a task thing though. Like a tool assisted, like you gotta go frame by frame. Like you could do it, but you have to have superhuman fingers. Superhuman fingers! I do not have superhuman fingers. God. Every time I play this though, I think of the Nuts and Bolts version, and the Nuts and Bolts version is genuinely bad. Like there's a lot there's a lot to say about Nuts and Bolts and how, you know, a lot of the challenges feel kind of janky, but the Saucer of Peril Returns challenge is especially janky, and I couldn't even tell you why. It just doesn't feel good to do. It's not even particularly hard. Like, I remember struggling with it, but when you sort of get the hang of, like, the way that the shooting works in Nuts and Bolts, it's not so bad. It's still just janky, though. Admirable for them to bring it back. That's a game that I would like to revisit at some point sooner than later. I started a 100% playthrough of Nuts and Bolts over on Twitch a while ago, and I kind of just fell off of it. Wasn't really feeling it. I like to play the game at least like once a year or so, like just to refresh myself on it. But I don't know, I wasn't feeling it last year, so maybe we'll try again this year at some point. I would like to play that game again. At some point in the distant, distant future, I'd like to do a proper series on that game. Because I have a lot of thoughts about it. Or maybe just a video. Like, do like a, I don't know, like some sort of like little review video or something for Nuts and Bolts. And actually write down my thoughts. That's something I've thought about doing for a long time too. Is just writing down my thoughts on a game and doing a video for it. Because, like, I don't usually do, I mean, all of the videos and content that I've ever made on the internet has been, you know, unwritten, like, off the top of my head, like, I'm just commentating on whatever I'm seeing at the moment. But historically, I felt like I would be really bad at writing, like, a script and reading from a script. But I think if it was, like, more of, like, a bullet point, like, you know, here's the topics that I want to hit on, and then still, like, have most of it be off the top of my head, and have it be, like, feel a little, ooh! Have it feel a little bit more natural. You know, I think those videos would be really fun to do, actually, so. And you know, get all of my thoughts in one place, right? Like, a lot of my gaming opinions are spread out over many, many videos and many, many streams and clips and things. And it would be great to have all of my thoughts about this particular game in one video for people to see. Nice shooting! You win two bleeping prizes! A primitive paper thing. Thanks. And this shiny gold thing, bleep. That's all my prizes gotten, but why not red again to try and beat your best score, bleep. No, I'm good though. Like, I don't want to. I have no desire to do that again. At least it's not like some of the games in this, where you have to do like multiple runs of it to get one Jiggy. Like any of the kickball games, you have to do those three times. The Dodge'em Dome, which we're about to do, we have to do three times. I'm just not about that life. You gonna go up again? Cool. Meanwhile, like, this is just a platforming challenge. That's what I'm saying, right? Like, some of the Jiggies feel so, I don't know, they all feel like very all over the place. I think it would be kind of neat if Banjo had multiple tiers of collectibles. You know, like have your Jiggies be like a mid-tier collectible and have like maybe like a crystal Jiggy or something that's bigger that you get from like a boss or like a crazy challenge that you have to do or like some other thing like that. That way that they can have Jiggies all be sort of the same sort of length to get. Like if a Jiggy takes longer than 15 minutes to get, then it's too long. That's what I feel. Cause like there are some Jiggies in this game that are like a whole quest line spanning multiple levels. And that's just too much. And I understand why people don't like this game as much as the first one because of that. But there's so much about this game that is lovable because they just upgrade so many things from the first game too. So I don't know, it's a little all over the place. At least it's not Nuts and Bolts. I love that game, don't get me wrong, I love that game, but you know, I'm still ready for a classic Banjo experience. Now I've talked about this before, where like because Nuts and Bolts exists and because Banjo has been in a lot of like racing games and other games like that, like he's been in Diddy Kong Racing, right? That was Banjo's first appearance, actually. And he was in, you know, there was Banjo Pilot that existed, the GBA game where you race in planes. It's very Diddy Kong Racing-esque. And then he was also in Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing for the Xbox 360. The Xbox 360 version of that game had Banjo as an exclusive character. That's a game that I would love to pick up and play. I really wish it was backwards compatible on the Xbox One, but I don't think it is. I looked it up to try to see if it was, but I couldn't find if it was or not. I'll have to look again. Maybe it is now. I don't know. Oh, well, I didn't finish my thought. My thought was, because Banjo's been in all these other types of games, I could see Banjo and Kazooie being put into any type of game. Like, could you imagine like a Banjo-Kazooie turn-based RPG or a Banjo-Kazooie like life sim? I mean, I don't know, it would work. Like just put these characters in any kind of game and just keep putting those kinds of games out there and throwing something at the wall. Like, I know they're not gonna do that because like it's high risk, you know, to do it. And at this point, like, if they don't make a classic 3D platformer Banjo game for the next one, then, you know, like, I feel like people will very much lose trust in them. But I feel like they should not shy away from the nuts and bolts deviation, you know what I mean? Like, I feel like they should be putting Banjo and Kazooie in every type of video game. You know, they're in Smash now, so they're in a fighting game. Like, just put them in any kind of game. I want to see those characters flourish. And really, you know, because it's like you got Mario, right? Mario's a platforming character, right? You got the 2D and the 3D platformers. That's what Mario is known for. But Mario's also in like a kart racer, and he's like he's got sports games, and he's got RPGs. It's like if you want Because, like, Banjo and Kazooie were created as, like a challenge against Mario. They were like, well, we saw Mario doing well. Let's make a game like Mario with our own character. And they did that. But then they didn't, you know, really expand on that too much. And I think that that really comes down to Rareware being sold to Microsoft. And, like, that whole transition period was really hard for them. Understandably, I think that it's a different case these days. Rare is doing really well with Sea of Thieves. You know, they're working on other future titles. They've got all these properties that they can, you know, have other companies use. You know, there's remasters and remakes of a lot of their older games coming out. I know there was a Battletoads game that came out at some point, which apparently wasn't super good. There was a Killer Instinct remake. You know, like, I think there was a Perfect Dark game in the works. I don't know if that ever came out. I don't think it did. But so, like, you know, these Rareware properties are being used eventually. I think they're just very hesitant to use Banjo because they know it's their number one, like, their number one IP. It's Rareware's most famous property, really, outside of Sea of Thieves now. Like, Sea of Thieves has gotten really huge. But I think that they're just very hesitant to do anything more with Banjo at the time, for the time being. I'm hoping that will change in the next couple of years. I'm hoping that all these rumors of a new game being developed or a remake or whatever it's going to be is all true, and that we get to finally see one in the next couple of years. And I'm hoping that this, like, this Nintendo Microsoft, you know, like, makeout session continues, because, like, that's been pretty great for everybody involved. Like, a lot of Microsoft Game Studios games coming to the Switch has been fantastic, and I hope they keep that up. Okay, so what else do we need to do? We unlocked the... We did the two things. We did all the things with Wumba. We did those things. We did that. Wow, did I do everything? Hold up. hold the phone. Hold the phone. Hold the phone! I'm missing a Jinjo and I'm missing 10 notes. And I'm missing a Jiggy that I can get. Because there's one Jiggy that I won't be able to come back... I'll have to come back for, and it's the one... where I'm getting Boggy's, or Mrs. Boggy's kids. Here, we can try for the get Jiggy cheat again, now that this is open. I think the only other one is maybe the... And now choose your fate. You win some gold feathers. Oh, thanks. Okay, I'm only gonna try it once, because I don't wanna waste my life away doing that. I think that's everything. Where am I missing two notes, though? Did I ever go in the scary hole? I'm sorry, did I ever go in the... Oh, I didn't do this. I didn't do this. I don't think I ever went in the scary hole either. We'll do that after this. I don't think I ever did that. We're gonna play it safe here. Just gonna play it safe real quick. It's fine. And... Nailed it. Okay, so that's all of the notes, but we are missing a Jinjo, and I know that's why I'm thinking where I didn't go into Scary Hole yet. And this is what I mean. Nom. I think there's a Jinjo in here. And a wonderful character that we haven't seen in a while. Oh, it's dark. Oh, it's dark. Hey, fairy man, get over here. Show me the light. I don't want to touch the teefs. This cave really needs to use mouthwash or something. The Cave of Horrors. Ah, look at all these horrible beings. Oh no. Weird killer alien. Look, it's the weird killer alien. Just so scary. The mighty evil dinosaur. She looks kind of cute and sad. And the ancient bearded camel. Ah, the scariest one of them all.
Hey, guys. I'm glad to see some familiar faces. Gobi, what are you doing in there?
Well, as you see, as you may remember, I was on my way to the lava world, but I got captured. Now that you're here, I'll soon be out.
Ah, we'll see about that, Beardy. Do you have any more money?
No.
Then get used to that cage, hump boy.
That's the way to treat an old friend.
Nah, I'll let you out. You don't need any money.
Great! I'm on my way to the lava world again at last.
See you later, Beardy. How long has he been in there? 2 years? Is that 2 years worth of beard? Can camels grow a beard? Someone Google that for me. Thanks, but I'm not going anywhere until the chuffing train is at Witchy World Station. Wow, are you swearing out here? Did she just swear at me? Till the chuffing train? Okay, I'm gonna free the one Jinjo. There we go. All right, let's go get the train to come to Witchy World so that we can get this dinosaur out of here. Because we're gonna need her later. I don't think I've actually been to the train station yet either. Oops, where's that? Hold on. I know there's a shelf over here. Oh, there it is. Ouch. Please. Please, for the love of God. Here, oh wait, I should get some more grenade eggs. Grenade eggs are probably the most useful of the new eggs, if you ask me. I feel like they have more uses than anything else throughout the game. Oh, hey, we can get another Cheeto cheat too. Bum 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 ba dum bum bum ba dum bum bum. I love the train. I love Chuffy the train, but like I feel like it's underutilized. Besides one very specific part of the game, like there's some neat little puzzles that go along with it, but I feel like it could have been so much more. When are we getting like? This, like, the Banjo-Kazooie equivalent to Spirit Tracks. That's what I want. I want Banjo to just drive a train everywhere. The Banjo Express. Banjo Expressy. Oh, there's one of the kids, actually. One of the kids in the corner here. We can't do this Jiggy.
Thank goodness you came. I'm really hungry.
Don't you think you've had enough?
No way. I just need a burger before I go find my mom.
Anyway, if you give him a burger, he's like, I can't walk, and you have to carry him, but you don't have the move in which you can carry him yet until a later world. So I gotta come back for that anyway. Chuffy is loading ore in Gilder Gulch Mine. Would you like Chuffy to pick you up? Yes, please. We did. God, I love trains. I should play a train. There's like a bunch of train sim games. And like there was one that came out for VR recently that was like model train simulator. And it's like you as a person and you can have like the VR headset on and it shows like a model train set up in front of you. You can just customize it and move things around and stuff with your virtual hands. I think I would dig that. I don't have a VR headset though. I gotta get one of those. Are they less expensive yet? I don't think they are. There we go, we've rescued the dinosaur and we'll deal with her later. But that is it for Witchy World actually, guys. Pretty sure. Let me take another look here. I think that's everything we can get here now. All but one Jiggy that we have to come backtrack for. So that's it, cool. In the next one, we'll go unlock the fourth world in the game and get it started. Thanks so much for watching. Appreciate you. Thank you for supporting on Patreon. And I will see you guys in the next one.